Hi, my name is Maraida Giassi. This video will represent the chapter 2 entitled Childhood Days in Calamba. Let me tell one of his lines. And this is, a tender childhood, lovely town, and rich fount of my felicities. And that quotation is one of his words. Before I proceed the topic, let me introduce his family. Francisco Mercado Rizal, the father of Dr. Jose Rizal. Francisco Mercado Rizal was studied in Latin and philosophy at the College of San Jose in Manila, and he died at the age of 80. Teodora Alonso Yolanda, the mother of Dr. Jose Rizal, she was educated at the College of Santa Rosa, also known College for Girls in the City, and she died at the age of 85. Saturnina Rizal, she was the first child of Francisco Teodora, and her nickname was Nanning. Pasiano Rizal, he is the first son of Francisco and Teodora, and he is the second child. Narcisa Rizal, she is the third child, and her nickname was Sisa. Olimpia Rizal, the fourth child of Francisco and Teodora, and her nickname was Ipia. Lucia Rizal is the fifth child of Francisco and Teodora, while Maria Rizal, she is the sixth child of Francisco and Teodora. Jose Rizal, he is our national hero, and Jose Rizal give us a lesson to everyone. And if you see his work, you will realize everything that you do for not capable of being a human. Concepcion Rizal, she is the eighth child, but unfortunately, she died at the age of 3. Her nickname was Concha. Josefa Rizal, the ninth child of Francisco and Teodora, and died a spinster at the age of 80. Her nickname was Pangol. Trinidad Rizal, Trining was her nickname, and died a spinster, and she is the last member of the family to die. Soledad Rizal, she is the 11th child, and her nickname was Choleng. Jose Rizal was born on June 19, 1861, and he died on December 30, 1896. He is our national hero of the Philippines. He is the second son of Francisco Mercado Rizal and Doña Teodora Alonso Riolanda, and he is the seventh child of the family. Pipi or Pipito was his nickname. He created a lot of poems that his mother encouraged her to make a poet. We all know that every children has a beautiful memory when they're young, but Jose Rizal had a different memory. He had a happy family because he always have a parental affection with his family and moral life. In the middle of peaceful life and being a religious boy or God-loving, he spent the early years of his childhood memories. The beauty of Calamba was impressed him as he grew up. His life was the happiest period for his childhood days in his natal town. A few kilometers to the south, the legendary Mount Makiling. And this is the picture of Mount Makiling. As you can see, this picture reflects how this Mount Makiling can make people interest or impress the place. This one is a church of Hacienda de San Juan in Calamba. Despite of this mountain lies, the coffee producing Batangas, spreading the Laguna de Bay, was a lake of poems and songs, which many sailboats gliding by the somnolent Talim Island, and a lot of flying birds. In the azure skies, passing another lake, the distance of north, you may see the Antipolo City, the famous mountain stream of Miraculous Lady of Peace and Good Voyage. This poem talks about his memory of his town when he say, "Thy face in precious memory infancy. O mother, friend most dear to me, who gave to life a wondrous charm." And he's trying to say with his mother how he want his mother to his side. And this one I read as an introduction of this chapter was, a tender childhood, lovely town, rich fount of my felicities, which put to flight all dismal arts. He studied at the Ateneo de Manila when he was 15 years old in 1876. Earliest childhood memories. When he was 3 years old, he's a weak, feeble, and undersized child. He always gets sick. But his memory with his family was the first memory for him. Garden that her father built for him, a little nimpa cottage. And he can play anytime and gain a loving care by his parents. In his boyhood memories, he narrated how he at the age of 3, watching in his cottage the Kuliawan, the Maya, the Maria Capia, the Martin, the Pipit, and other birds, and listening with the wonder and joy to their songs. In the nightfall, his mother gathered all the children and pray at the house of Angelus. When sadness feeling came to him, he remembered how happy the moonlight nights at the Azotti. Aya means maid. She always tell a story with the children. The imaginary told by Ara Arose, Rizal interest after the legend and the folklore. When Rizal did not take up his supper, Aya threatened him that the aswang, the nono, the tikbalang, and the turban bumbay will came to take him away. The Aya took him for a walk in the moonlight by the river when the trees cast caustic shadow on the bank. Rizal narrate his childhood experience and he wrote this: "Thus my heart feed on sombre and melancholy thoughts, so that even while still child, I already wander on a wing of fantasy in the light region of the unknown." Rizal's children were surely ties of love and embodiment, because they were bred full of love by their parents. They called their parents Nanay and Tatay. Unlike our generation, we have a unique or special call with our parents. When Jose joking with his brother to call Uti, and they called Rizal Pipi or Pipito. His nickname was known of people in Calamba. Pasiano was the closest to Jose, and they built a strong bond of friendship, stronger than more blood. Pasiano loved Jose, and he was proud for being Jose's genius. Jose loved most his little Concha. Jose older than Concha in 1 year. Jose always played with her, and he learned a sweetness and brotherly love. But unfortunately, Concha died of sickness in 1865. Jose cried to lose her lovely sister. Rizal said, "When I was 4 years old, I lost my little Concha, and then for the first time, I wept my tears of love and grief." That the first sorrow he experienced. Devoted son of church. At the young of Rizal, he is a religious, and he grew up a good Catholic. Rizal began to take part in the family prayers when he was 3 years old. His mother taught him the Catholic prayer. When he was 5 years old, he was able to read, halting the Spanish Bible, and his mother always decided to teach Rizal very well. Rizal loved to go to church and pray. He joined the religious procession. He was serious divine that he's laughing to call him Manong Jose by Hermanos and Hermanas Terceras. He wrote a poem entitled Al Niño Jesús, 1876, La Alabanza Íntima entre la Religión y la Buena Educación, 1876, and La Virgin Maria. And this is his work for being devoted Catholic. He often heard a mass in the parish church at the 4 a.m. When he studied in Biliran, Laguna, he began his life as a student in Ateneo de Manila in June 1872, but he continued praying. Father Loncho Lopez, one of the men he esteemed and respect in Calamba during in his boyhood, pilgrimage to Antipolo. Jose and his father went to pilgrimage to Antipolo on June 6, 1868 to fulfill his mother's vows. And Doña Teodora was not accompanying them because she was giving birth to Trinidad. Jose and his father rode in a casco means barge, and it looked like a flat boat. Jose did not sleep at the whole night because he was amazed in the Pasig River. He said, "The magnificence of the watery expanse and the silence of the night." Many years later, he wrote his experience in that place. He said, "With that pleasure I saw the sunrise. It was the first time I had seen the bright gray strike with dazzling effect the road surface of the vast light." He was wondering every time he remembered how he impressed that place. First education from mother. We all know that all children had a first education by their parents. And Doña Teodora is the first teacher of Rizal. She is a good teacher. When he was 3 years old, he learned alphabet and the prayers from his mother. The humble prayers which I rest fervently to God. Doña Teodora was patiently and lovingly with him, but she strict a tutor. Seeing that Jose had the talent for making a poetry, she encouraged Rizal to write his poem. Doña Teodora gave her best to teach Rizal that she learned in college. But when Rizal misbehaved, she prank him with her slippers. At one time, the age of 5 years old, he resisted to wear sinamay camisa because it was gross and he was inefficient to his skin. She slapped his butt for disobedience after that whipping. He wore the coarse camisa without protesting with his mother. At another time, Jose and Josefa played while their parents have a regular sisters. But Jose ignited a fuse to a bottle of powder. Then, soon a loud explosion rent the quiet afternoon, followed by scream in pain. Doña Teodora quickly went to the garden, and she saw Josefa crying with a burned face. Jose gained a spanking with his mother. Rizal did not understand the Spanish. He could not read the expression on his face. When she took a book from him, she scolded him to listen to her, and that's the first time she do. When she began to read the story, Rizal listened to her full of childish diligence. He paid little attention to the reading. By chance, Jose yawned and his mother noticed how he was not interested. She stopped reading and she said, "I am going to read you a pretty story. Now pay attention." When he heard the word story, you may saw him full of curiosity. His mother translated him into Tagalog, his mother repeatedly the warning of the old moth. Her mother settled upon it, and she directed to him. He heard her mother, but curiosity made the light seem to him, and he attracted that beautiful flame. He invaded the luckiest insect. The Story of the Moth by Doña Chudora tells a story to Jose Rizal. And I will show you a video that you may compare the story and how Jose Rizal invaded this insect. His uncle Gregorio was a lover of books and taught him to work hard. His uncle Manuel was a strong and husky man. He encouraged Rizal to learn swim, fencing, wrestling, and other sports so that a frail body Rizal acquired a prominent body. His uncle Jose was an educated person and he's the youngest brother of Doña Chudora. Jose encouraged his nephew to sketch. Rizal had a talent since his childhood. He always doing to draw the picture on his book and his sister's book that is called by his mother. He can sketch the animal and a person out of the mood. He can also sketch the flower, fruits, river, and mountain. Rizal loved to ride on a spirit pony which his father bought him and take a long walks in the meadows and lecture with his big black dog named Guzman. In his room, you can see many statues that he made, and his sister teased him, "What are you doing with so many statues?" He replied, "Don't you know that people will erect monuments and statues in my room in the future?" These are indeed prophetic words from him. Prodigy of the pen, Rizal was not only skilled in brush, but also in pen. He was born in poet. Rizal, at the young age, his mother encouraged him to write his poetry. He was already writing poems. That's the first time he wrote was in Tagalog, entitled Sa Aking Mga Kabata. Before he was 8, he wrote Tagalog drama. And Gobernador Silio bought him the manuscript from Little Jose for 2 pesos. 2 pesos during the time had a big sum amount, and that the first money he gained with his work. Rizal spent his time the shore of the lake in Laguna de Bay. He was thinking what was beyond the lake. He was dreaming what he might over the other side, and he saw a gorgeous civil lieutenant cunning injuring some unarmed and inoffensive villagers. He saw a no strings put upon a brutality act of a violence. He asked himself if in the land which lay across the lake, the people live in the same way. I wonder if there torture any countrymen with hard and cruel whips merely on suspicions. Did they respect the home? Or over yonder also, in order to live in peace, would one have to bribe tyrants? At the young age, he wrote to his friend Professor Blumentritt, in a view of these injustice and cruelties, although yet a child, my imagination was awake, and I made a vow dedicating myself, somebody to avenge to my any victims. With these ideas in my mind, I studied, and this is seen in all my writings. Somebody, God will give me the opportunity to fulfill my promise. In the 100 children was born in all over the Philippines, why one boy, Jose Rizal, had a rose to fame and greatness? People ask. There are 3 influences which cause some people has to be great and some other are not. Gradually the fire engulfs the small moth, is lust for fire and fury in approaching to get offered to him to death. It is similarities the outcome of the author, Dr. Jose Rizal. He is tempting by the power of writing and subversive writing. Outside the fire of Concord, like a small moth, he was condemned to die by exchange for his fury to obtain the light of justice. And that's my report in chapter 2. Hope you like it.